Welcome to Mittweida University of Applied Sciences TV studio. I think here you can feel the beating heart of Mittweida. A lot of our events take place in this studio. I also sat or stood here quite often myself for conferences and talks. I've talked in front of people numerous times. Scientists, entrepreneurs, politicians, students, but also in front of the general public or even children. But I still get nervous every single time. But it has to be done, because it's part of my job as a scientist, not only to gain new insights, but also to communicate them broadly, be it through social media, videos, or open science formats. But you have to work a bit different. More open, transparent, at eye level, and you have to keep in mind your target audience. So please dispense all the technical terms, even if it's a bit hard for us scientists, yeah, to speak in a normal and easy to understand way. I mainly deal with acceptance and sustainability communication in the European area. That is the successful communication of social, economic, and ecological aspects and activities of organizations. This includes the planning, implementation, and evaluation of communication measures to generate or increase the acceptance in society. To illustrate this, let's take a look at Saxony here in Germany. The majority of the population is in favor of energy transition. My research shows that, for example, 65.6% of the population accept hydroelectric plants in their vicinity, 62.7% accept solar plants, and 38.8% accept wind turbines. By comparison, a coal-fired power plant is accepted by only 5.6% of the population. In general, the acceptance level of regenerative energy is high, but civic protest will take place in many instances if a plant is being built. In such cases, proper communication can ensure that the residents do not delay or even prevent the construction of the facilities. The goals are to convey knowledge and information and to involve the local residents. Possible measures include participation formats at the level of hearings and consultations, educational projects, use of, and much more. So, where do you stand on hydropower, wind or solar power, or domestic resource extraction?